In this video, we're going to derive an identity for the cosine of the sum of two angles. We'll be using the unit circle definition for the sine and cosine, those are the trig definitions, the Pythagorean identity, and the distance formula between any two points from algebra, and we'll be using a little algebra as well, to find an identity for the cosine of a plus b. Before proceeding, you need to already know these facts, since this is what we're going to be using. So if you have a point on the unit circle, call it xy, where the terminal side of an angle intersects that unit circle, then the ordered pair is cosine theta, sine theta. So if the angle's theta, remember the point where it intersects, the x value is just the cosine theta and the y value is just the sine theta, and this is by definition. This is one of the trig definitions. The second thing we need to know is the distance formula between any two points. So if you have any two points, x and y, so let's just call it x1 and y1, and the other ordered pair x2, y2, then this is the distance formula. Now some of you may see it written as x2 minus x1. It really doesn't matter the order you subtract because you're going to square that number. And then finally, the Pythagorean trig identity for any angle, theta, sine squared theta plus cosine squared theta equals 1. Now remember, theta could be anything. Theta could be x plus y. Theta could be 2m. But what it's saying is if you have any angle here, if you square that, the sine of that angle plus, and then you square the cosine of that angle, it actually equals 1. So the goal, we want to find an identity for the cosine of a plus b. First of all, make sure you are clear that the cosine of a plus b is not equal to just the cosine of a plus the cosine of b. We could show that's not an identity by plugging in some angles for a and b. So why don't you put the video on pause and try that? Like you could let a equal 0 and b equals 60. Degrees, let's say 0 degrees and 60 degrees, and compute the left-hand side of the equation, see what you get, and then compute the right-hand side of the equation using the same values for A and the same value for B, and you should get that they're not equal. So go ahead and try that. All right, so if we want to show that the cosine of A plus B is not equal to the cosine of A plus the cosine of B, you could pick anything you want for A and B. So as an example, I just decided, hey, what if I used 0 degrees for A and 60 degrees for B, what would happen? So as you can see, I'm putting in 0 degrees for A and 60 degrees for B on the left side of the equation and simplifying. Hopefully you all know the cosine of 60 degrees is 1/2. And then I'm plugging in 0 degrees for A and 60 degrees for B on the right-hand side of the equation and simplifying, and I get a different number. So the left side was 1/2, but the right side was 1.5. So these certainly are not equal. What about if you tried something else? It doesn't matter what you try, it shouldn't work. How about if you try 0 degrees for B? Let's see what happens. What if you put in 0 degrees for B? So this is going to change a little, right? All right, let's do it. So we're going to put in 0 degrees for A and 0 degrees for B. So you're taking the cosine of 0 degrees, and what's the cosine of 0 degrees? That's 1. Now is that the same thing as the cosine of 0 degrees plus the cosine of 0 degrees? Well, that's 1 plus 1, or 2. So as you can see, it really doesn't even matter what values you put in. You probably note that you're going to get a different number on the left side as on the right side. So this is not an identity. These are not equal to each other. So now let's go ahead and see if we can derive an identity for the cosine of a plus b. So here's the idea. We're trying to find the cosine of a plus b. So I'm starting out with this unit circle. The red circle is a unit circle, so this ordered pair over on the right is the ordered pair 1, 0. And first thing I'm going to do is draw an angle A. It could be as big as you want, but I just made it this big, and it hits the unit circle right at this point. So what would that point be? That would be cosine A, sine A by definition. All right. And then I'm going to take another angle B. Now we've got to be careful. I'm talking about angle B is just this part here, right? So it sort of ends where A is. So it doesn't come all the way from the x-axis. So it's just this little piece here is B. All right. So how do we get this point right here? It's not cosine A it's not the cosine B, sine B, because B didn't start over here at the x-axis. But I do know that together, since these are right next to each other, this piece here is actually the angle. That angle there is A plus B. Okay, so if this is A plus B, then this ordered pair, by definition, is the cosine of A plus B, sine of A plus B. Okay, so what I've done is labeled some ordered pairs here. Now, we're going to use the distance formula to do a proof. There's a little bit more to this, but let's just go ahead and see what happens if we take the distance between these two points. Let's see, you can't see that real well. Let's make it, what color should I use? How about this? So we're going between here and here. What if I wanted to get this distance? Okay, between these two points. That's called a chord. It's a line segment between two points on a circle. So how would we get the distance? Well, we could use the distance formula. It's the square root of the difference of the x values squared minus the difference of the y values squared. So that would be the cosine, so you can write it like this, the cosine of A plus B minus the cosine of A, that's the difference of the x-coordinates, and I'm going to square that, plus, I'm going to do the same thing. I'm sorry, I meant to write 1. We're going all the way down here. So the x-coordinate is 1. I could use brackets or I can use the parentheses. And then over here, we've got the difference of the y value squared. So this y value is sine of A plus B minus 0 squared. Okay? So let's simplify that just a little bit inside the square root. And it's going to probably take more than one line here. All right, so this is a binomial squared, basically. So it's the first term squared. So cosine A plus B squared, remember, could be written as the cosine with a little squared right here. That means cosine of A plus B times the cosine of A plus B minus, and it's 2 times the product, so it's going to be 2 times the cosine of A plus B. Here's where your algebra comes in. You've got to be careful with your algebra. Plus the last term squared will be plus 1. All right, so I've just squared this first part. And what about the second part over here after the plus sign? Well, since you're just subtracting 0, this is just really the sine of A plus B. And that whole thing squared could be written just as the sine squared of A plus B. Not sure if I got that all in there. Hopefully you can see that. Let me move it a little bit. Make it a little bit smaller. Okay. Wow, okay, now, check out what's going on right here. I've got the cosine squared A plus B plus the sine squared A plus B. There's an identity right there. So what does that equal? Cosine squared of theta plus sine squared of theta, that would be equal to 1. But in this case, instead of theta, I have A plus B, but it's the same thing. So that's going to equal, together, that adds up to 1. And I have this other one over here, plus that one, right? Minus 2 cosine of A plus B. So I'm almost done. 2 minus 2 cosine a plus b. Now I can't take that out of the square root, but that is the distance between these two points here. All right, so that's the first part, just getting that distance. Now what am I going to do with that? I'm going to now take this angle B, all right, and I'm going to write it down here, angle B. So really I'm going downward, so this is really negative B, the angle negative B, right? So what ordered pair would that be? That would be the ordered pair cosine of negative B sine of negative B. All right? Now what I want you to think about is this angle A plus B, the original one I'm looking at, notice that this right here is actually the same distance, because if you look at it, this size of this angle negative B that you're seeing here is really the same size as the B there. So the distance here, or I'm sorry, the angle here is also A plus B. That's actually the angle A plus B. Not easy. Almost there. What that means is that this first chord we drew between these two points is the same as the distance between these two points. And we know those two points. Look at this point is cosine A sine A, and this point here is cosine of negative B sine of negative B. We could simplify this one down here a little bit, because the cosine of negative B is the same as the cosine of B, because the x value is the same. It's an even function, so that's cosine of B. And the sine of negative B, well, the sine's negative down in this quadrant, so this is negative sine of B. So what we're going to do is take these two ordered pairs, okay, and we're going to find the distance between those. So that's our next step. We'll go to a new page to do that. Alright, so here's the drawing again, and so what we're going to do is do the distance formula. We're going to use these two points this time, okay? Alright, this is where, boy, you got to be careful with your algebra. So it's the difference of the x-coordinate squared, so it's cosine A minus cosine B squared plus the difference of the y-values squared, so it's the sine A minus, well, this coordinate is a minus sine B, so it's minus A negative sine B, and then that all has to be squared. All right, so now we have to do our arithmetic underneath the square root. So this first one, again, is you're squaring a binomial, so it's the first term squared, cosine squared A, minus 2 times the product, cosine A, cosine B, plus this last term squared, which is cosine of B squared, which remembers, that means cosine B times cosine B, which is cosine squared B. Right, what's going on over here? We've got the sine of A plus the sine of B squared. So I'm going to write it that way. That's the sine of A plus the sine of B squared. Okay, so I still have to do that. Before multiplying that out, let's check something out. Do you see this cosine squared A and this cosine squared B? Oops, sorry, that's not going to help us yet. That would be convenient if it was a sine squared B. Oh, sorry, we can't do anything yet. Okay, so let's go ahead and let's multiply that out. So this is going to be huge and long. So it's going to be like a continuing square root. So we've got this cosine squared A. I'm just going to copy what I have so far. Minus 2 cosine A cosine B plus cosine squared B. And now I got to multiply this out. So I'm going to have sine squared A plus, this will be 2 sine A sine B. I'm going to have to kind of continue it here, so it's still under the same square root sign. I don't know how to really show that. So just kind of this continuing that square root sign. We've got 2 sine A sine B. And squaring the sine of B times sine of B is plus sine square B. Okay, so remember this is all one big, long bunch of stuff underneath this big square root. And now we can do this. See my cosine squared A, and look at, I've got A plus the sine squared A. So that's going to add up to 1, right? I also have this cosine squared B added to this sine squared B. That's also going to add up to 1. So you know what? Those, everything you see there in the yellow and the red, those are going to add up to 1 plus another 1, which is 2. So I'm going to write 2, so this is going to be equal to, all underneath the square root sign still, 2, and I also have this minus 2 cosine A cosine B, minus 2 cosine A cosine B, and then I also have this plus 2 sine, what happened there, sine A sine B. And that's as far as I could go. Now what I'm going to do is take my other distance I had before, because these should be the same distance, and they both had square roots. So if I square both sides, I'm going to get what's underneath each square root. So now we're going to take what's under here, and we're going to show that that's going to be the same thing as what was under here. Okay? So I have 2 minus 2 cosine A plus B is equal to the 2 minus 2 cosine A cosine B plus 2 sine A sine B. You need like a huge piece of paper so that you don't have all these lines. All right, so at this point, notice you have a 2 on both sides. So if you subtract 2 from both sides, you end up with this negative 2 cosine of A plus B equals negative 2 cosine A cosine B plus 2 sine A sine B. And now, remember what we were trying to do? We were trying to find out what the cosine of A plus B was. So we're just going to divide both sides by this negative 2, which means each term gets divided by negative 2. And I'm going to finally get it. Cosine of A plus B equals cosine A cosine B minus sine A sine B. Voila! That is the formula for the cosine of the sum of two angles. That'd be pretty hard to expect a student to be able to figure that out, but hopefully if you go back and watch this slowly and you write out all the steps yourself, it'll make sense. The next step will be to use the formula to compute, like the cosine of 60 degrees plus 45 degrees or something like that.